My name is Will Dawes. I'm the director of chapel music here at Somerville. And this is Somerville College Choir, looking forward to singing to you for the next 15 or 20 minutes or so. This college was established in 1879, relatively recently. It was one of the first colleges to be constructed so that women could come and study at Oxford University and officially get degrees. The chapel was left as a bequest in the 1930s. Like most college chapels, it has two sides facing each other, Adoro Pärt and useful maps of that end. But that's where the similarities finish. This is a non-denominational chapel. We don't subscribe to any particular branch of Christianity or indeed any religion. Those of all faiths and none are welcome here at any time of day to come and just sort of be in this space. The music is heard, Arvo Pärt, Estonian composer commissioned by King's College Cambridge for their annual festival of nine lessons and carols. The funny story behind it being the reason it's so short in this book is because Pärt is a very expensive composer to commission. So when they said, here is how much we can offer you, they said, I will give you 1 minute of music. And lo and behold, that was it. And we continue with another piece on the subject of Mary, similar to our founder, or the name of the college is named after Mary Somerville. This is a piece from 500 years ago by John Taverner, a formerly musician at Christchurch Cathedral here in Oxford, Martyr Christi Sanctus. We are beginning along with a piece by a lady called Cecilia McDowall, a modern British composer who, like me, studied at Edinburgh University. And we're very fond of her music, and indeed trying to champion more works by not just her, but all female composers, and try and right the wrongs of inequality that 500 years of mostly male composers has sort of led. It's a very fervent piece. It's about communion. It's the most sacred piece that we'll sing now, and you can almost sort of sniff the incense in the air. It has hints. I mean, lots of you will know the Allegri Miserere, the famous top C. This piece has lots of echoes of that particular style, and indeed a couple of top C's in it. three more of those to finish with. Firstly, an American folk song, Shenandoah, arranged by James Erb. This is an extraordinarily simple but moving piece of music. And towards the end, you just get the sensation that you've got a group of singers singing very strongly in the middle of a large valley, and the sound bouncing around, and you hear the tune sort of wafting around. And after that, John Rutter, I mean, how can we do concerts without someone like him? He's written some very good music, and some other music as well. But this is a jazz about setting of a Shakespeare sonnet. It was a lover and his last. First, a bit of American shout.